So check this out. Okay, we got our hairpin on the HV side. We got the spark after is just kind of hanging out for a minute. Here's the rotary. Okay. Now, there's slight gaps on here, so it's not really touching, so it isn't able to arc across it. But, there's two interesting things going on here. You see the rotary's actually causing this xenon to fire, and that's also off from that. But, you notice the power source for this rotary? Where's it going? It's going through a resistor, which has zero effect on the RPM. Now traditionally, we have potentiometers on these. You know, one of these deals right here, in series with that, and it would control the speed. That's how we were controlling the speed before. There's no change in RPM. When I vary, this is, I don't know, 30 to 50 ohms, essentially, in series here. But look closer. So that's the first thing. But now we look closer, and see those power wires? Where are they going? They're going to the neutral, and they're going to the other side of the hairpin. So, that hot wire is not even getting to these. So essentially, the rotary is in parallel with the MOT primary, and they're both being driven off of the hairpin circuit. And now the rotary actually will discharge when it wants to. And it's able to fire the xenon bulb and turn this lamp. It needs adjustment. When I do that, it's obviously better.
Yow!
Don't do that. That's even stronger than it was before. With the 120 volt side. I gotta get this more stable. To make gold out of junk. You know how that is. But it's firing quite regularly. Open up the gap, I can add even more disruption, but that seems to be detrimental at this point. It's running off the low voltage hairpin side of the primary. The resistor has no effect on speed. Why? Why does it have no effect on the speed? How is there enough current going through that primary to run that motor? It's not as fast as it used to be, but definitely sufficient. I wonder what happens if we try to open this gap for my protection. And we'll get rid of that thing for a moment and just look at the rotary and close the gap. Really not much difference. This high voltage capacitor in series here, you would think they'd be restricting more current. Hey, what was that? Okay. It's actually helping with the way it can turn pulse that motor. Needs to have a little bit more torque. Turn the rotor backwards, don't get much effect. There's not a whole lot of torque on here. You can feel the pulsing when the rotary fires. Self-driven rotary from the hairpin, discharging the hairpin.